Text alternatives, or guideline 1.1, means that you should provide a text alternative to all content that is not text on your website. Now, there are a few exceptions which we're going to talk about later, but basically every time you put content that is not text, unless it falls into a couple of exceptions, you must provide a text alternative. And that does not mean images of text, it means electronic text. And the reason that is because electronic text is very versatile. You can zoom it, you can have a braille refresher device translated into braille, you could have screen readers announce it. It is so versatile and it is so accessible, and it's also the easiest to add to your website. You know, it's much easier to just type text than take a photo or hire a professional photographer to take a photo. As to how exactly to provide text alternatives, it varies from medium to medium. For example, this is my website and this is my headshot on it. And what I did is I provided an alt attribute to my image element. So my alt attribute is Stefany Newman, which is my name. However, when it comes to images, it depends greatly on the context. And providing a text alternative for image doesn't necessarily mean that you have to describe the image. Sometimes it does, but sometimes you have to transcribe the meaning of the image or the context of the image. So for example, this is my headshot. So I did the alt attribute that says my name, but I did not describe my features. I did not say a woman in her 20s with black hair and brown eyes, because it doesn't matter. People are not going to hire me for my appearance. They're going to hire me for my skills. But I transcribed my image so that the screen reader or someone who visits my website would know with visual impairments would figure it out that, okay, so she put an image of herself on her website, okay? Now, when it's necessary to directly describe an image in the alt attribute tag is when the context of the image is important for the overall page. For example, we are on a website that sells cosmetics and we are browsing an eyeshadow palette, and what the eyeshadow palette image represents is extremely important to us because we want to know whether we want to buy it or not. And to do that, we have to look at the image. Now, this is a very bad example because, I mean, this is a good example of a text alternative done wrong, because the alt attribute for this image is product image. And this is absolutely horrible because, first of all, you should never add the word image or picture in an image, because the screen reader is going to announce it anyway. It's going to say graphic, unless it's a diagram or a chart, because the screen reader wouldn't know the difference between a graphic or an image or a chart. But the word image is redundant, so you shouldn't include it in your alt attributes. And product image is absolutely useless. Now, what they did was, what the web designers did, what web developers did here, is they know that alt attributes needs to be filled in, so they just did something randomly, and they apparently, obviously the site doesn't have an accessibility consultant, that's why they're screwing it up. So the correct way to fill in the alt attribute is going to be, you have to describe the product in very much detail. So you're going to start with a case of eyeshadows with four shadows, and then you have to describe the color of each and every individual shadows. Now, when it comes to cosmetics, with eyeshadow, sometimes brands like to include really stupid names for their colors of the eyeshadow. So for example, instead of saying a yellow or the real color, which is not yellow, which is like gold or something like that, for example, they're gonna name it socks or Cheetos or bananas or something like that. So you should include the fake name the brand added, and you should include the real color name. Okay, so this should be changed from product image to an eyeshadow palette with four shadows: white, gold, brown, and light brown. Now you should use the real color names. So this is obviously not brown, it's more like mauve, but you should, you know, consult the product manager and they will tell you. This way, when a screen reader announces, it will announce the names of the shadows, you know, and the colors, and then users will be able to understand what this image is about. But product image, this is absolutely useless, and it's just going to add clutter, and it's so bad. Here we have the second image of this product, and see how they The brand stupid names I told you about, like Claudia, Gloria, those are not color names. But then in parentheses, they added Warm Ivory, Gold, Espresso, Bronze. And this is really good. So what they did is in the product image, they added images of text. So the text is above the eyeshadow swatches. However, the auto attribute is still product image. So what they should have done is just repeated the image of text in the auto attribute, because the screen readers are not able to read images of text. Another common mistake is with the list of blog posts that have an image preview. What a lot of blogs do, and which is incredibly wrong, is whenever you have an image preview, like we have with this list of blog posts, they duplicate the title in the image alt attribute. And this is so wrong. Let me show you. The title of the first article is Sell in Person with Point of Sale in Squarespace. And the alt attribute reads Sell in Person with Point of Sale. It's the same as the title. And this is wrong, because whenever a screen reader lands on that article, it's going to read the title of the link and it's going to repeat the same title for the image. Now, what you gotta do here is just add a no alt attribute, because those images are not content. They're just for eye candy. They're just, you know, to attract attention, but they don't serve any content. But I see this done so many times, and this is in violation of guideline 1.1. A good usage of the alt attribute is this page from the Worldwide Fund. Now, the alt attribute reads giant panda in tree. And this is important, because this image is a content, because this is a page about pandas. So what they did is that they describe what is happening inside the image in the alt attribute. And this is great. And this is how it should be done. Remember, always describe the context and the meaning of the image, not necessarily the image itself. When it comes to audio-only content like podcasts, it is imperative that you provide the transcript of the podcast. We have here the CodePen podcast, and they don't have a transcript. They have a description, they have time jumps, they have sponsors, but they don't have a transcript. And those things that they added are really good. You know, they have links and CodePen links. I think those are the links they mentioned on the podcast. It should be. But they don't have a transcript. So what happens here is, this is in violation of guideline 1.1 and guideline 1.2 time-based media. But I just want to show you that when it comes to the guideline 1.1 provide text alternatives, it is not only images. It is any content that you add, unless it falls into a couple of exceptions, that is not electronic text. And here they are in violation because they have provided no transcript. So if someone is deaf or hard of hearing, they won't be able to, you know, to consume the product. An example of providing a transcript with your podcast is the Smashing Podcast. They have the podcast player where you can play and listen to, and right beneath it is the transcript that is, you know, transcribed word for word with the names of the speakers that are currently speaking. And this is amazing, and this is what you should do to achieve accessibility and to meet guideline 1.1 and 1.2. The first exception to non-text content that you don't have to provide an alternative to is input forms, or input, any inputs that you add to your page. And the reason for that is because that content requires user interaction. So if you just add the text alternative, it's not gonna do anybody any good. So what you gotta do though, is you have to provide a name or a label for each input. And when I say name, I don't mean the name attribute, I mean a label, which is called a name. So the way I did my contact form is accessible because it has a label with the email input, and it has a message label for the message. Another exception to this rule is if you have non-text content that is a test. For example, if I want to take this quiz online, if I put a text alternative, meaning that if I provide the answers in electronic text, it's going to defeat the purpose of the quiz. So what you gotta do here is structure your quiz in a way that is easily understandable by screen readers. So this quiz is structured very well because it has labels, it has headings, the next button is very clear, So that means even if I am using a screen reader, I'll still be able to complete the quiz. The other exception to the rule is when the experience added to the content is purely sensory. For example, if you're listening to a symphony or if you're watching a speed drawing, these are very popular, for example, a portrait or something. Now, these cannot be accurately transcribed through text alone, but you should at least add, you know, an identifier. For example, the title for the symphony should be, you know, the symphony in Paris. And the speed drawing should have a title, something to describe, for example, speed drawing of Emma Watson. And that will be sufficient. The other exception is caption. Since you cannot add the solving of the capture in text, because then robots will be able to fill it in, what you can do is add a phone number where people can call if they need assistance with the capture. Or you can provide an alternative capture that is easier to solve by people with disabilities, but it is at the same time impossible to solve by robots. And the last exception to the rule is if you have content that is purely decoration, then you must add a nulled out attribute, or even better, include that content if possible via CSS. Here we have in the footer a disclaimer that says always cool, never cruel. That means this brand doesn't test on animals. And they have a puppy picture, but the puppy picture is just a decoration, you know, it adds cuteness. It doesn't add any content. In this case, they actually added an out attribute that says puppy illustration, but it's completely redundant and you're not supposed to do that since this image is only for decoration. Also, while we're on the topic of including images via CSS, never include a content image via CSS background image property, because you won't be able to add an out attribute and search engines would just skip it. So I have seen this happen a lot with product images. They're just added as background images for some reason, and this is in violation of the guidelines, so you shouldn't do that. Let me show you a more complicated example. This is a medical diagram showing the position of the teeth inside the lower jaw, mouth. I'm not a dentist, I don't really know. But the old attribute for this diagram just says picture of human tooth. And not only that, they used title case, which you shouldn't. You should use sentence case when writing out attributes, unless it is showing the name of something, but anyway. So the auth attribute gives no information whatsoever to the screen reader. What they should have done is described in detail what the diagram depicts and add the word diagram, because the screen reader is going to say graphic. But this is a graphic of a diagram. However, the screen reader is not going to know that. So what they should have done is says diagram of the lower jaw teeth. At least this is what it looks like, and then started, okay, at the end there, the incisors, then we have canine teeth, and then we have premolars, you know, in more detail than I'm telling you, and then we add a close-up to the tooth, and then you start with the Emmanuel, dentine, pulp cavity, root canal, etc. Now over here they have explained some of it, however this information below the image diagram, is not the same as the information depicted in the diagram. So that's why additional add attribute with the text should be added. But if the text below the diagram was the same, then you could use area labeled by and link it to the ID of the text.